thinking about getting one of
the lorries were very happy, the services were out before we left. So then we just filling it up. Didn't have a lorry move.
So, July the 2nd, we're all going to meet there. Well, at least we're not with Declan
and one
of them.
There are times and dates on our calendars each year which call us to gather to pay our respects to those who have served, those who have gone, and to celebrate those who continue to serve in our armed forces. This is one of those days, and the National Memorial Arboretum is one of those places that has become special in the hearts and minds of many. We find conflict in so many other places, humanitarian needs, peacekeeping roles and more besides, all of which place demands upon our forces and those who supply and service them, such as the Royal Fleet Auxiliary. Regular and reservist, one in intent and purpose, continue to place the needs of this nation and its protection and its service within the aegis of NATO, the UN and other bodies at the forefront of all they are. Men and women continue to march away while those at home pray for their return. As we begin our tribute to those serving, remembering those who have served, those whom we love and see no more, let us pray. Lord, we know that life is fragile and the needs before us are so often cruel. We pray that the presence of God, his protection and peace, his purpose and love, might be with us as we pray and those for whom we pray this day. Those we remember now gone, and the families of all who today will find themselves in places of challenge and danger. May all people of all faith and none find within them the living word that brings comfort and peace, that sustains and upholds us all. Amen.
Good morning. I am Graham Morley, I am Vice Lord Lieutenant of Staffordshire, and I am delighted to be here today to represent His Majesty's Lord Lieutenant of Staffordshire, Mr. Ian Dudson. As you know, this is an opportunity for us to celebrate the work of everyone involved in the armed forces communities, and to thank them and their families for all they do to protect our way of life, our democracy, and the freedoms we enjoy. Being able to do this here at the National Memorial Arboretum, the year-round National Centre for Remembrance of all who have served, is especially appropriate. The Lieutenancy has been in place since the days of Henry VIII, when the Lord Lieutenant was responsible for raising local militia to serve the needs of the King. Thankfully, the Lord Lieutenant and his officers, such as I, no longer need to gather groups with pitchforks, lumps of wood, or other local available weaponry. However, one of the responsibilities of the Lord Lieutenant, as the Sovereign's personal representative in Staffordshire, is the ongoing liaison and interaction with all parts of the armed forces, regulars, reserves, veterans, and cadets across the county. On a personal note, I am pleased to have friends in all of the armed forces, and I have personal involvement with the Staffordshire and West Midlands North Sector Army Cadet Force and the Reserve Forces and Cadets Association. I therefore appreciate the importance of recognising volunteers and other auxiliary roles that play an important role in the support of our armed forces. As we thank and celebrate all those involved today, we also thank those who have made significant sacrifices, many of whom are recognised at this wonderful place of peace, appreciation and reflection. So to finish, as we recognise and celebrate Armed Forces Day with others across the nation and on the Commonwealth, on behalf of the Lord Lieutenant, the Lieutenancy and the people of Staffordshire, I simply, but sincerely say, thank you.
I'm Philippa Rawlinson, have the great pleasure of being a director here at the National Memorial Arboretum. And I'm delighted to be welcoming you all back here to the Arboretum on this fine summer's day. Although, unlike last year, I do have precautions. So, delighted to be welcoming so many of you here as we celebrate all that our armed forces do for us. Yet again, Armed Forces Day is set to be one of our busiest days of the year. We have never had so many cars pre-booked at the start of the day. Motorbikes, however, is a different matter. There might be a certain Saturday in October that hits this one. I've been talking about Armed Forces Week and what it means in the press in various interviews. And while we do have a fun-filled weekend here at the Arboretum, where families can find out about the many and varied roles of our armed forces, it is a moment to say thank you to those who still serve, for their and their families' sacrifices. Sacrifices they make, like generations before us, for all of us, despite never having met us. Last month, we honoured the extraordinary service of a generation of ordinary young men who, after the end of the Second World War, were called up for national service. Over 2 million were conscripted. And we heard from those who found their time rewarding and exciting, and from those who could not wait to get back to their normal lives. Some of the young servicemen found themselves far from home, in the Pacific, witnessing nuclear tests, or in Korea, where sadly too many lost their lives and are recorded on the Armed Forces Memorial. Others never left these shores. One common theme we heard time and time again was the camaraderie amongst comrades these men, young men found. As we mark 60 years since the end of national service, 70 years since the end of the Korean War, and the immense contribution that those that came to these shores on the Empire Windrush 75 years ago made to our armed forces and country, we are also thinking about those more recent anniversaries and how we will mark the end of 15 years since the end of Optelic and 10 years since the end of UK operations in Afghan next year. Thinking next year to make sure that we remember the service not only of those who served in D-Day 80 years ago, but also the sacrifices made in those more recent conflicts. And as I said at the start, the sacrifices are still made on our behalf by those who serve today. Last October, we marked our own 15th anniversary, the 15th ride to the wall took place. I spoke about camaraderie in the with the national servicemen and what they told us. And that word for me instantly makes me think of ride to the wall community and the friendship and support the wall has shown each other and us here at the National Memorial Arboretum. A friendship that is deep and enduring and has grown over many years. A friendship that has grown with the Arboretum and supported us beyond the tremendous financial contribution that enables us to care for and share the stories of the ever-growing collection of memorials with the next generation. Thank you. I'd like to introduce my friend, Martin Dickinson, Ride to the Wall founder, to share with us the result of the 15th Ride to the Wall. Over to you, Martin.
Thank you.
good afternoon, everybody. It's going to be very, very short. During times of economic and financial difficulty at the moment, there's one thing that really touches me, and that's right to all. After 15 years, as Philippa mentioned, we're still here, we're still going strong. And one of the most important things we do is unselfishly, we remember each and every single name on the walls of the Armed Forces Memorial. That's a massive thank you to you guys. For the last, the pandemic, I've been a bit worried. The cheque presentations throughout the year grew and grew and grew. And there was an awful lot of pressure on the team. I put a lot of pressure on myself. And then we had the pandemic, and even in that year we raised £123,000, but it dropped a bit. But as I said, I've been speaking to other charities, and they all seem to be struggling, they all seem to have difficulties with, as I said, people having other issues to deal with. But I would like to say, once this cheque's presented, in the times that we're in, absolutely superb, absolutely massive. It's a credit to each and every one of you. And with that, I'd just like to hand over to one of our patrons, Major General Ronald Kirkland.
Hello, everybody, fellow Wallers. This RTTW, I can see the brand. A lot of you are wearing it, so not everyone's wearing it. There are some merchandising opportunities available if you want to catch up. I can see not everyone has ridden in on a bike today, motorbike, but feel free to join us at, as Philippa said, first Saturday of October. This place becomes transformed into a sea of motorbikes and black leather. We gather down there at the Armed Forces Memorial, estimated between 10 and 15,000 people come to that event. It's quite an extraordinary spectacle. It's a very emotional and yet uplifting day where we pay our respects to those who no longer ride by our side. And we do that thanks to Martin Dickinson, who founded this movement in 2008. And here we are, after 15 years, not just going strong, getting stronger, as Martin said. The monies raised through that ride and through the merchandising, another tip, buy your merchandising here today, will contribute to the enormous sum that we give to the National Memorial Arboretum each year. And it's not just the cheque, as you will see today, there's something very tangible being handed over, this thing here, which we're going to unveil in a second. That is on top of the monetary value of the cheque. So, fellow bikers, fellow wallers, we're all immensely proud to be bikers on a day like this, which sees the commemoration and the celebration of all that we do for the NMA. Thank you for riding with us today. Thank you for coming today. But if you really want to see something special, come back in October. Thank you. £150,000. And today I'm delighted to hand over the keys to the RTTW four-wheel buggy, which is going to be specially commissioned to take people up onto the National Arboretum, to the Armed Forces Memorial, so that people in that buggy, they can they too can ride to the wall.
Trustees here at the NMA, but I also served 30 years in the Princess Mary's Royal Air Force Nursing Service. This is the second child. Thank you for this amazing event, Martin. It's just amazing. Thank you to each and every one of you. I am really in awe of the work of the Royal Ride to the Wall and support that they give to the Ride to the Wall community. I was very lucky last year to be invited with the riders in 2022, and it was an amazing experience. The support from the local community was also immense. The spectacle of all those riders arriving at the NMA was such a poignant moment. So on personal reflection, the respect shown is heartwarming, and I wish to thank each and every rider for their efforts. And I thank you all on behalf of the Armed Forces community. Thank you.
In closing, I'd just like to add mine and the team's thanks to all of you, and for not only the amazing cheque, but Bunty the buggy. Alliterative, rolls off the tongue. Bunty is an extraordinary gift, and as Amon said, will enable people to make their own journeys to the wall if they're unable to walk. And I think it's very fitting that such an extraordinary gift has an extraordinary name, Bunty. And there is a long story about why we've called her Bunty, or why the wallers have selected to call her Bunty. So if you want to find out more, do ask one of us why they've chosen Bunty. So to close, thank you all to everybody that's participated in and made our service a fitting tribute to the Armed Forces. And thank you to all of you for joining us today. I hope you will enjoy discovering some of our new memorials and engaging with the activities spread across our 150 acres of woodland. While you're doing that, I hope you learn a little bit more about the many and varied roles of our armed forces with your friends and family and make new memories together. Thank you, and I look forward to seeing you next year.